Dear clients, welcome to Phillip Capital's Weekly Market Watch. I'm Roy Chen, microanalyst from Phillip Securities Research. Today, I'm going to share with you the China macro and equity strategy. China's economy continued its pace of bottoming out for the past few months, though not with all pillars on fire. November data shows that fixed asset investment, retail sales, industrial production all show improvement or at least have sustained their paces of gains achieved earlier. Official manufacturing PMI stayed unchanged at 50.6 in December, indicating a mild expansion in manufacturing activities. On the other hand, HSBC manufacturing PMI, which focuses on small and medium enterprises, rose to 51.5 in December from earlier 50.5 in November, indicating a faster expansion. December official non-manufacturing PMI rose to 56.1 from earlier 55.6, indicating a faster expansion in non-manufacturing business, while HSBC services PMI fell slightly to 51.7 from the earlier 52.1, indicating a slightly slower expansion. We also observed significant improvement in December export growth. However, we are not over-optimistic as external demand is likely to stay weak in the earlier months of 2013 due to the unsettled US fiscal cliff and the prolonged Europe debt crisis. By trading partners, we are observing a major acceleration in exports to ASEAN countries, driven by the robust local demand for infrastructure spending. Export to US is still hovering at a low level, near 5%, while export to Europe shows a slower year-on-year contraction. Housing price and inflation, two of the government's main considerations for giving out further monetary loosening, show signs of picking up. September, October, and November data for housing market show that through the past 3 months, there were an increasing number of cities seeing month-on-month price increases, and fewer cities are seeing month-on-month price drops. This indicates a risk of reviving property price bubble, which would likely to hinder the government from monetary loosening in the near term. Inflation reported 2.5% in December, exceeding the market predicted 2.3% pace and the 2.0% pace in November. The hiking inflation is mainly from the rising vegetable price due to the coldest winter in 28 years. Producer price index reported a 1.9% year-on-year drop in December, narrower compared to the 2.2% year-on-year drop in November. The narrower drop reflects reviving industrial activities. With the rising property prices and inflation, the scope of further monetary loosening by the Chinese government to support the yet strong reacceleration is eroded. Though the necessity of such loosening is not urgent as the economic bottoming out continues. For equity market, we maintain the overweight rating on China for both short-term and long-term perspective. PE ratios for HSCEI at 10 times and CSI 300 at 12 times are residing near the lower end of their respective historical ranges, indicating cheap valuations and therefore attractive buys from a long-term perspective. Following China's economic bottoming out, HSCEI has trended up since September, but it was not until December that we observed a strong rally in CSI 300 index. The resistance level near 2300 is already cleared and should turn into a support if there is a pullback. The index is currently challenging the resistance level near 2500. Despite possible short-term pullback as the market consolidates profit, we expect the upward momentum to continue due to the improving economic fundamentals and the recent transaction volume expansion. Therefore, the 2500 level is likely to be cleared, and the next stop for CSI 300 index is at 2700. As for HSCEI, the index is near the 12,000 sentimental resistance level and is likely to continue heading north. A mix of resistance levels through 12,000 to 13,500. We encourage our clients to read our monthly China strategy report for more details on our asset strategy, as well as the wide array of ETFs and CFDs available that clients can tap on to trade the market outlook with. That's all we have today. Do stay tuned to next week's video. Thank you.